Welcome to another episode of Qt Widgets and More. In this episode, we'll start with a small quiz. The quiz is, how do you spell definitely? Yes, that is the right answer. If that's not what you got, maybe you should watch this episode where I'll teach you how to set up a spell checking plugin for Qt Creator. It isn't rocket science to install this plugin, but let me walk you through it nevertheless so you have an idea of what it looks like. First thing, you go to the URL that should be available on your screen now, and then you scroll down on the site here and you find releases. It's super important that you get the right version of the plugin matching your Qt Creator. And if you have an older Qt Creator, then you go and choose the plus 35 releases here and you'll find an older version. I know that mine matches here, and we can just validate that release for Qt Creator 4.13. So you go to your Qt Creator, you will go to Help, and from there, about Qt Creator, of course. And you can see 4.13, so that matches my version. Then you'll choose whichever of the zip file or tarjset file that matches your operating system. I got a Windows 64-bit, so I'll choose this one here. I will open it just in Windows Explorer. And it has two files inside it. So I'll choose both of them, Control-C to copy them. And then I'll go and find my Qt installation directory. So this is the topmost directory that that came out of my SDK package with Qt. And I'll need to find Tools, Qt Creator, and then just paste those two files in this directory. That was the installation of the plugin itself. Easy, right? But we also need a dictionary, preferably with the language that we write our code, or rather write our code comments and our strings in. So go back to the web page and go to the top of that page again. Click code here to go to the top page of the hierarchy. And you'll scroll down until you see a link. And here is the link. This is a English dictionary as they come from LibreOffice. If you have preference of another language, say Russian, then Do svidaniya, меня зовут Jesper. That's all the Russian I learned for 3 years in high school. But nevertheless, this is for the English versions. You'll choose whichever variant of English that you prefer, and you go on the plane and right-click and choose download. Be aware, you need to download both the, if we go for the US here, the DIC file and the AFF file. If you forget the AFF file, it will work, but it will not understand plural version and stuff like that. It's time to restart your Qt Creator if you haven't done that already. Otherwise, you will be pondering for quite a while why nothing works. So I restarted my Qt Creator. Let's just validate that it actually got loaded. So help, about plugin, start spelling, spell checker. And you can see that there's a check mark next to the spell checker, which indicates that it actually did load the plugin. Next, go to Tools, to Options. Inside your options, search for the spell checker down here. And you have a few different things that you can configure. First of all, you can configure which spell checking library to use. It supports Hunspell. Well, that's all that it supports. I find it a bit funny that he still kept that in just as a user interface element, just for the future when more spell checking backends was supported. In this line edit here, you need to specify where your downloaded dictionary was, or as on my system, I just found it directly inside the LibreOffice installation. Here is the location of my private dictionary, where I have all the words that I believe the world should be spelling my way. So my spelling of definitely might be in this file. This option here is rather important if you are on a large project. What this option tells you is that you should only spell check the current file. Otherwise, whenever you start your Qt Creator, all the files on the project are spell checked right away slightly annoying. Okay, let's see what it looks like in my user interface now. You can see some text here. It's a comment. So the spell checking plugin supports spell checking comments and strings. And you can see there is a misspelling here of extract. Imagine you extract, I would likely have said extracted or something like that. So right click on it here. I can choose spell checker and choose extract if that was what I wanted to write there. I could also ask it to give me suggestions. We can try that on the next one. Control Alt S. Rather good to remember that shortcut. So down here, Control Alt S. And here's my list of suggestions. Let's check January as the correct spelling here. Another thing you can see in the user interface is that there's actually a new tab down here called Spelling Mistakes. Currently, there's none because I didn't have more mistakes here, but let's try to make this misspelled again here, and this looks good. I guess that's an artifact of me recording this setup here. Usually, it looks pretty nice down here. And finally, there's also a sidebar to this. So if you press Alt 0, then up here in the sidebar, you can choose spelling mistakes. And you can see here is there's one spelling mistake, and that spelling mistake is in a string. So that's the difference here is, let me just add a comment here. I spell badly. There we are. I spelled badly. Now you can see there's three spelling errors, but only one of them are in a user visible string. Well, there's no guarantee that the string is user visible, but it's in a string that is much more likely user visible than a comment. That's it for this episode of Qt Widgets and More. If you have problems with your spelling, KDAB is likely not the right people to reach out to. But if you have a problem with Qt 3D, C++, you need training, you need services around it, hey, reach out to us. There is a link right here that tells you how you can get in touch. I'm Jesper Pedersen. Thanks for watching this episode.